First, we will learn what is communication. Communication is an exchange of meanings between individuals through a common symbol, common system of symbols. Okay. Communication is not prevalent in human being only. Animals also communicate among themselves. Okay. It is in between, means communication is in between insects, birds and other animals. The mode of writing symbols, which we call language, is unique to man only. Okay. This language, what we call language, where we use symbols to write and use different languages. Okay. So, this language is unique to man only, okay? Because it is not available in between insects, birds or animals, okay? Yes, they communicate, but they don't have their language, clear? Man has created many more ways of communication, whereas animals world have limited ways to communicate between their own kinds. Whenever you hear birds twittering and creeping, dogs barking, cats mewing, tigers roaring, or a cricket making noise in night, all these are communicating with members of their own species. Okay? Man has developed communication skills manifold. He means man communicates verbally and non-verbally, or can combine both of them in many ways. These ways of communication can be very simple or very complicated also. It is a vast area of system which you would love to explore when you grow up. Okay, later you come to know about more things about this mode of communication among men. Okay, but whenever you appreciate a painting, a building, a song, a dance, a movie, a story, a book, or for that matter, a nice meal fondly prepared by your mother, you are in communication with other person, provided you attach a meaning to it. Okay. However, we shall confine ourselves with very few means of communication. These means have their own story individually and collectively, which must have been told to you in lower classes. You must have learned in your lower classes. But these stories are about man's effort to overcome time and space and to make communication easier and faster. The various means of communication are, it is through post office, by telegraph, by telephone, by teleprinter, by text, by fax machine, by email. Okay, these devices are used from person to person or very rarely between a group of person. Okay, these devices are generally used to communicate with one person. Okay, means between two person. Okay, the following means of communication means now we will see the mode of mass communication. Okay. Now, what we learned is means of mass communication, and these means are used to convey news to a large audience. These entertain as well as make efforts to build opinions and attitudes towards definite ideas. Okay. These are means of communication are newspapers, radio, television, cinema, website on internet. Okay. The efficiency of the post office has greatly improved by the efficiency of the transportation and telecommunication system. Earlier, when the post was sent on foot or horse-driven mail, okay, now it uses the faster means such as railway, trains, and aeroplanes to deliver mail. Money transfer is done by teleprinter or fax, okay? And all the countries of the world are interlinked and exchange the mails with each other. Besides being a means of communication, present day post offices have taken many other responsibilities as well. What are these responsibilities? Post offices are acting as banks. It collects electricity and water consumption bills, issue railway and airline tickets, and in some cases insurance facilities are also available in post offices. The government of India increased money for its projects through the post office by issuing national saving certificate of various kinds. Telecommunication systems cover up telegraph, telephone, radio, and television as well as fax. Present day world is known as the world of telecom and computers because both of them have complemented each other effectively. Geostationary satellites have further added to their efficiency. But we can't forget the role of optic cables in providing better services. Optic cables consist optical fibers, which provides better service, better telecommunication service to us. Okay. Sometime back, telegraph means in earlier days, telegraph was the most important telecommunication system. It had great advantage over the visual system, which was being used to send messages over long distances. Though the name of Samuel Morse, 1844, appears as an inventor of telegraphy. But the fact is that there were many contributors for the development of telegraphy. Samuel Morse provided the Morse code, which was effectively transmitted with the machine developed by Alfred Weil. Further improvements kept on taking place, and effectiveness of transmission was much better than the initial machine. After Second World War, new technology became available and telegraph was replaced by fax machine around 1980. Now we will learn about telephone. The telephone is the central part of modern telecommunication. Alexander Graham Bell invented the telephone in 1870, though almost at the same time, Elisha Gray also designed a telephone. Like other invention, a good many people's work went in it, and further improvement were made in its functioning even today also. Now, availability of geostationary satellite and computer operated system have made progress to an extent that we carry cell phones with us everywhere. Okay? Email or electronic mail is a very successful communication tool. It has been possible because of the development in the application of computer science. Newspaper has been a mass communicator to pretty long time. Its place in any society is unique. It is one of the most important means of mass communication. Okay, newspaper. And radio. Radio on the face of it seems to be more a source of entertainment. But as a mass communicator, it is more important than other medium. It was invented by G. Marconi, but its performance and size both have changed since then. Microchips and geostationary satellite have improved upon its reach and quality tremendously. Television was invented by John Louis Baird. This John Louis Baird was inventor of television, perhaps most liked mass communicator. So this television is also a mass communicator. All of us handle it every day and pick up program of our choice. Next comes cinema. Cinema is another mass communicator where the message is usually conveyed through a story enactment. Okay, it can be most persuasive than most of the other mass communicators. Next is websites. Websites on internet have a dubious role as a mass communicator, but it is an effective means to inform the public. Okay, here you have to you have to visit the website to search the information, then only you will get the information. Okay. So these all are the most important means of mass communication. So in this chapter, we learned that communication is an exchange of meaning between individuals through a common system of symbols. Then we learn man has developed communication skills manifold. He communicates verbally, means we can communicate verbally and non-verbally, or can combine both of them in many ways. These ways of communication can be very simple or very complicated. Okay. Next, we discussed about means of communication. So, what we discussed, what are the means of communication? These are post office, telegraph, telephone, teleprinter, fax machine, by email. Okay. Next, we discuss about means of communication walk on different platform, generally in for mass communication. Okay, what are the means of mass communication? So we learned about newspaper, radio, television, cinema, and websites on internet. So this is all about chapter number 12, that is sending and receiving messages. Thank you.